A new sci-fi thriller, a drama, and a horror flick are the newcomers in the box office. Our resident movie critic, Manny the Movie Guy, tells us his pick of the week.
That there is something underneath all of the isms that we experience in our lives across the world and across time.
Selma director Ava DuVernay returns with a moving study on race in Origin.
Happy birthday.
Based on the book Caste, The Origins of Our Discontents by Isabel Wilkerson, Origin is a biographical drama that shows how Wilkerson's personal tragedy catapults her into writing the book and uncovers the ugly truth about race in America. At times, the film sounds too academia, but have no fear. DuVernay honors the source material with a compelling narrative punctuated by indelible performances, specifically ingenue Ellis Taylor as the author.
Trauma by ignoring it.
Origin challenges conventions, and that's a good thing.
I write answers.
And for that, Origin gets 3.5 out of 4, a very important movie. Kisses. Another film out in theaters is the slasher flick, Founder's Day. Mix politics and psycho killers, and we get an intriguing horror whodunit. Founder's Day is a satirical political slasher about a series of ominous killings in a small town leading up to a mayoral election. Who's doing the killings?
Tricentennial.
From the Blomquist brothers, Founder's Day is fun and scary and pays homage to the genre. And for that, Founder's Day gets 3 out of 4 wickedly entertaining kisses. And finally, we have ISS.
The Russians always knock 3 times.
3 Americans and 3 Russians coexist in the International Space Station. So what happens when our countries clash down on Earth?
Oh my God.
The beauty of the film from director Gabriella Cowperthwaite is its mixture of authenticity and thrills. It's like watching a pressure cooker explode.
Houston, do you read?
And in the middle is Ariana DeBose. This is her follow-up film to her Oscar-winning role in West Side Story.
Because it was unlike anything I'd ever been given the opportunity to do.
Take a wild ride to outer space with ISS.
It's thrilling, affecting. I mean, I clapped in the end. I enjoyed it.
And for that, ISS gets 3.5 out of 4. They Can Hear You Scream in Space. Kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.
A few weeks before her much-awaited Hollywood debut, Filipino actress Liza Soberano proudly shares she now has her own production studio. Gretchen Folido gives us a look.
Timer starts now.
Liza Soberano is blooming and happy. The actress who turned 26 last January 4 shared with ABS-CBN News that she celebrated her birthday traveling solo and soul-searching.
I decided to go on a solo trip by myself, which I've kind of turned into a yearly tradition of mine. Mm-hmm. I do this thing where I kind of go soul searching. So last year I did this like a wellness retreat in the States. This year I went to Japan for 3 days. I kind of wanted to just take a step back and recalibrate and really think about what my priorities are in my career and my personal life and everything. And in order for me to do that, I kind of just need to take myself out of the environment that I'm in,
yeah.
Go somewhere new to get a new perspective and just, you know, recalibrate.
2024 is shaping to be a year of resurgence for Liza, with projects in front and behind the camera.
2024, well, of course, Lisa Frankenstein is coming out in February. I have an upcoming project. It's a US-based production, but it will be filmed here in the Philippines. I also started my own production studio, and I currently have 7 projects in development.
Oh my God.
Some of which I will be acting in, and some of them I am completely just on the back end producing them for other artists.
But Liza, your message to all your fans who have nonstop supported you all the way.
I just want to say thank you to all of my solo fans that have been really like joining me throughout this new transition period of mine, or this journey into building a career outside of the Philippines, and also, of course, to my Liz Ken fans who, despite me not being able to do Love Team projects anymore, have been there for me. I hope I can make you guys proud with this new movie that I'm coming out with, and I love you guys very much.
Fans don't need to wait much longer as Liza's Hollywood debut movie, Lisa Frankenstein, will finally hit Philippine cinemas on February 7.
Time to try and fix up ways. Better just to...
Gretchen Fulido, ABS-CBN News.
Sad news in the local entertainment industry. Filipino cinematographer Romy Vitog has died at 86 years old due to blood cancer. His family and friends share how the industry legend changed their lives. Rafael Bosano returns with that story.
Photography is my breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Legendary cinematographer Romy Vitog will forever be known by his colleagues for his keen eye for detail, meticulous ways, and love for the film and television industry. Vitog's vision helped many directors establish defining moments in films like Mga Bilanggong Birhen, Kapag Langit Ang Humatol,
Akin ang Huling Halakhak,
Sa Aking Mga Kamay, among many others. On Thursday, Vitog's family announced the award-winning cinematographer succumbed to cancer of the blood. Vitog's vibrant career spanned decades. He started out as a print photographer in the 50s until becoming a cinematographer for national artist for film and broadcast Lino Broca. From there, he would establish the look of more films and become one, if not the most accomplished cinematographer in the country. Film director Carlito Siguin Reyna has worked with Vitog for critically acclaimed films, Hihintayin Kita sa Langit. If there's one thing he recalls about Vitog, it's his utmost respect to the industry and its people.
I think people should remember about Romy's work. It's not just his mastery of cinematography, but he was a hard worker and he was always a student and he was a great collaborator. He was a true perfectionist. Mahilig siyang magpasa ng wisdom niya sa iba.
Another director, Ryan Carlos, has also worked with Vitog for two decades. Their most memorable collaboration being the Susan Roses Cineserie Classics Florinda in ABS-CBN.
And naalala ko, tuwan-tuwa sa kanya si Maricel Soriano kasi pag iniilawan daw siya ni tatay, parang may cosmetic gel. Lalo silang gumaganda kapag si Tatay Romy ang nag-iilaw sa kanya.
But aside from being a profound cinematographer and colleague, Vitog is also a friend, even family, to people on the set.
Happy birthday, Direct Ryan. More birthday.
Carlos was more scheduled to visit come. Vitog next week, but that visit now is one that he never wants to make.
Hindi ko kaya yung kahapon kasi buong magdamag akong umiiyak na pa ito na si Direct Ryan, di ba iniintay mo siya? Na ano, inihintay mo siya na kausapin ka. Di ba magkikita kayo next week? Sabi ni Vijay, Tatay, magkikita ulit tayo. Nauna ka lang. Maraming salamat sa lahat ng naituro mo sa akin, sa lahat sa aming mga filmmakers.
Vitog showcased his excellence in cinematography one last time in 2018 for the ABS-CBN primetime series FPJ's Ang Probinsyano. Despite his achievements in film and television, his son Vijay said there was one recognition he yearned for.
National artist, yung pangarap niya kasi yun. Sabi ko nga sa kanya, no, ano, bago siya mawala, yun ko po, maging national artist ka pa.
Vijay says more than being a gem in Philippine cinema, there is one title he will always be known for, a great father.
Love your work. Love your work.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
You've probably heard of Raining in Manila, the hit song of Filipino rock band Lola Amor. But at the Philippine Arena in Bulacan on Friday, Filipinos got a rare chance to witness the song performed by award-winning band Coldplay. During Coldplay's Music of the Spheres concert, its vocalist Chris Martin sang a few lines of the song in Filipino and surprised everyone when he called Lola Amor on stage to sing it with him. Coldplay's concert also had a special attendee. Malacañang confirmed President Marcos was among the thousands of Filipinos who watched the British band live. The show lasted for almost 2 hours, with fans singing along to their songs like Yellow, Fix You, and Something Just Like This.